He wanted to go as far away as he could from what had occurred at Neverland. And what farther place can you think of but Bahrain?
The Kingdom of Bahrain, a tiny island nation off the coast of Saudi Arabia.
I like to call Bahrain the little kingdom that can.
J. Adam Early is the United States ambassador to Bahrain.
It may be small, but it does things that nobody else does. And one of the most important things is it is a welcoming and tolerant society in a region not known for being open and tolerant.
And Bahrain was tolerant enough to host the most eccentric of Americans as Michael Jackson began his self-imposed exile as the guest of this man, Sheikh Abdullah Hamad Al Khalifa, son of the King of Bahrain.
Sheikh Abdullah had a friendship with Jermaine Jackson.
Claire Hoffman has been reporting the Jackson story for Rolling Stone.
Jermaine had converted to Islam and had worked on music with Sheikh Abdullah, who was this big pop music fan and who had musical aspirations himself. So Michael called Sheikh Abdullah, and somehow on that phone call, Sheikh Abdullah decided to pay Jackson's remaining legal fees for the Santa Barbara case.
And then took him in.
It took him in.
So began the Arabian Nights of Michael Jackson. Dateline was given exclusive access to this luxurious villa in Bahrain, where Jackson stayed with his three children, all courtesy of his new benefactor, Sheikh Abdullah.
In America, he was Michael Jackson the star, the icon. Here is Michael Jackson the person.
Ahmed Al Khan is a friend of Sheikh Abdullah. He also became one of Jackson's closest confidants when the singer arrived in Bahrain. This is his first television interview.
He looked beaten. So people here, Abdullah, myself, all the people around him, really helped Michael recover really quickly. They gave him his space and they let him recoup. They gave him his rest. They gave him his privacy.
He says Jackson and Sheikh Abdullah developed a strong bond.
He really looked at Michael as a brother. He really protected him. They shopped together, they joked together, they traveled together.
And they made music together. The Sheikh agreed to finance Jackson's life in Bahrain, and Jackson was expected to record some songs on the Sheikh's new record label called 2C's Records.
They signed a deal that by 2012, Michael Jackson would be productive. He would produce two albums.
Gerald Posner is the chief investigative reporter for the website The Daily Beast.
He would come up with a Broadway-type musical, and he would also write an autobiography. And all of this would be done under production companies that Prince Abdullah would have.
Michael Jackson seemed to be putting his life back together and on someone else's dime, enjoying a leisurely life with his three children. He may even have used this restful time in the desert to end his dependency on prescription drugs.
Everybody wanted a piece of him. And here he felt a bit safe and secure from the people. And then when he was among the right people, he was himself.
Mohammed bin Sulayem is an off-road racing champion and entrepreneur, as well as a close friend of Sheikh Abdullah. He says he never saw Jackson with any drugs.
I can only say what I experienced from all the time that we spent together. I've never seen him using a drug.
At first, Jackson seemed to blend in fairly well in Bahrain, a country where a lot of people cover their faces in public. He wore an abaya, the traditional Muslim dress. But as the months went on, Jackson apparently wore out his welcome when a few public appearances outside of Bahrain generated that traditional Michael Jackson controversy.
He went into the ladies' bathroom and started to apply makeup in a shopping center in Dubai. And an Arab woman who was there took a picture of him. And he called over his security guards. They grabbed her. They confiscated her camera.
And Jackson's friendship with Sheikh Abdullah began to fall apart as well. The Sheikh was spending millions of dollars on his new friend. But Jackson hadn't lived up to his end of the deal. No new album to add to his catalog, no Broadway musical, no autobiography, just a handful of songs that had never been released.
Sheikh Abdullah I think was a good influence, a very good influence in Michael. He was hoping for a lot of things, but I think Michael, he was not strong enough to deliver.
And so this relationship ended the way a lot of Michael Jackson's business affairs ended, with a lawsuit. The Sheikh sued Jackson for $7 million. These two former partners in song eventually settled for an undisclosed amount. But the whole episode put Jackson back on a plane again. This time headed literally for greener pastures.
Michael called me to be a part of his charity song. It was for the Hurricane Katrina relief. And I don't know if they're still going to release the song.